Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the annual Amy Uebbing Gala and Auction Virtual Edition for 2020. It is a unique set of circumstances that we are coming to you today virtually in small groups. However small you have it, is one or two or a few more of your friends. All the same, we're hoping that you enjoy your time here this evening and supporting Bishop Foley Catholic High School. We hope that you enjoy your meal and drinks this evening. While that's happening, we're going to be running pictures of all of the baskets along with some nice dinner music behind the scenes while you enjoy for the first hour of our presentation this evening. At this time, I'd like to introduce Father Tony Richter, who will start off with a blessing for all of us, and then Frank Acavetti, principal of Bishop Foley Catholic High School, with a message for all of you.
Welcome, and it is good to have you here to the Amy Uebbing annual auction, and it's a virtual auction today. And it is great that you are here, and it is awesome that you support Bishop Foley Catholic High School. Today, as we come together, we bless our food and thank God for this great food. And so we'll begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Loving and gracious God, we thank you for all the gifts you give us, the gift of education and the gift of our benefactors here at Bishop Foley Catholic High School. We ask you to bless all of this food and bless all of those who are part of the Bishop Foley family. We ask you to, as we come together to pray, bless us, O Lord, and these are gifts which we are about to receive from thy bounty, Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Enjoy your meal, and thank you for supporting Bishop Foley Catholic High School.
Good evening. I'm Frank Acavetti, and I welcome you to the Amy Uebbing Annual Auction. It's fitting that Bishop Foley's first auction without Amy Uebbing quite some time is named in her honor. She was a tireless champion for Catholic education, and we here at BFC are blessed to have had all of her efforts bringing students in our doors and keeping them here for all these years. One of the greatest strengths that Amy had that she inspired in all of us was to keep on making certain that Catholic education was available to each and every student who wanted one. And that is what tonight is all about. We cannot make this school possible without your financial support. And so, as you type in your bids and continue to raise your wagers, do so knowing that every single dime goes to help finance Catholic education for our students. It keeps our doors open, it keeps them in the building, and it allows us to provide the amazing, undeniably Catholic, academically excellent education that you've all come to know and love. I thank you on behalf of the staff and greatly appreciate your time, your efforts, and your financial support of Bishop Foley Catholic. God bless you all and good luck tonight.
Thanks, Frank. Enjoy your dinner right now and the music. We will be back when the sections start to close. Enjoy! guys, we would love to be with you, but we can't. So show us what's happening at your house. Send us your pictures using hashtag 2020 BFC Auction. guys taking pictures today? We would love to see them. We would take pictures if you were here. So why don't you send them to us or put them out on social media? If you do, use hashtag 2020 BFC Auction.
Good evening. I'm Trevor Tile, the admissions director here at Bishop Foley Catholic. Thank you so much for taking the time to tune into our first ever virtual edition of our annual auction. I hope you have an amazing time tonight. In these unprecedented times that we're living in, there's a lot changing in the world around us, including here at Bishop Foley. One of these things is the implementation of FACTS into our application process. For current families, FACTS probably sounds a little familiar because it's currently utilized for our tuition payment plans. Our hope in implementing it into our applications is that we can create a more comprehensive and user-friendly experience for our future ventures when they apply here. Additionally, we've also waived our high school placement test requirement for this year due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Our hope is that we can provide a stronger emphasis on character and academic performance when our future ventures apply. Lastly, we've had to change the way that we present some of our most popular and prominent admissions events, including high school nights and open house, both of which now include a virtual component for those who are unable to attend. In these changing times, there's a lot that Foley has to adapt to, but our hope is that we can do it in a way that will benefit our students because we are fully committed to their continued success and prosperity, and we sincerely hope that these changes reflect that. Thank you so much again for tuning in, and have a fantastic night.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, there's a special ticket called the preview ticket. This lets you in to the auction an hour and a half early, usually when we have it on site, and it's from 5:30 to 7. It allows you to peruse the tables and baskets bid early, as well as enjoy champagne, tray passed appetizers, chocolate-covered strawberries, and a chance for a $4,000 reduction in tuition. I am going to draw the name of the winner of that $4,000 tuition reduction right now. As soon as I mix this up, because I don't want anybody to think I'm cheating. All right, so the winner is Christine Kenny. Congratulations, Christine Kenny. You are the winner of the $4,000 tuition credit. Congratulations. Thank you. Hey guys, we would love to be with you, but we can't. So show us what's happening at your house. Send us your picture using hashtag 2020 BFC Auction. Thank you. guys taking pictures today? We would love to see them. We would take pictures if you were here. So why don't you send them to us or put them out on social media? If you do, use hashtag 2020 BFC Auction. At this time, I'd like to talk about an award that we give to a parent who has gone above and beyond, who is exceptional in their dedication of time and energy to Bishop Foley. It's called the Heart of Foley Award. It is given sometimes to just one person and sometimes to many. At this time, I would like to introduce to you the Heart of Foley Award winner for this year. The person I want to give this award to at this time has been around since 2008. She has two students who have become alumni of Bishop Foley Catholic, yet she is still here diligently giving her time and energy to this event, the annual auction. She is the auction chairperson for acquisitions, and she has been that for many, many years. I know that Amy would have wanted to give her this award this year, and I think she is an exceptional candidate for it. So I would like to introduce to you, ladies and gentlemen, the 2020 Heart of Foley Award winner, Patty Landreth. Patty, congratulations on your award, and I'd love to be there with you right now, but I know two people that are with you, also Heart of Foley Award winners, Karen and Tim Maskell. We're going to present this award to you right now.
Congratulations, Patty, on being selected the Heart of Foley, a very deserving nomination, a very deserving individual. I know that you would have been at the top of Amy's list, and thank you for continuing to be part of the Foley auction and so on. Thank you so very much. God bless you and congratulations.
guys taking pictures today? We would love to see them. We would take pictures if you were here. So why don't you send them to us or put them out on social media? If you do, use hashtag 2020 BFC Auction. Ladies and gentlemen, the Rise Up campaign has been going on for a few years now. It was one of Amy's passions and something she was trying diligently to get done before she left us. I would like to introduce to you at this time, Rich Uebbing, the husband of Amy Uebbing.
Good evening, I'm Rich Uebbing, husband of Amy Uebbing. On behalf of my children, Chris and Cam, graduates of class of 2010, and my daughter Caitlin, class of 2014, along with Amy's sister, Michelle, and Janine, mother of Zach, class of 2021, I would like to express my gratitude to Bishop Foley Catholic for the honor extended in Amy's memory, naming the auction in her memory. She would be humbled by the wonderful gesture. For those of you who had the pleasure of knowing Amy, you know what Bishop Foley meant to her. She gave so much of her life to Foley. The things that were important to her were family, Foley, and Central Michigan University. We shared wonderful memories of many of Bishop Foley's auctions. As a matter of fact, the first auction that we attended way back in 2005, we won the 50-50 drawing. Little did we know at that time what impact the auction would have on our futures. Amy enjoyed being a part of planning for each year's event. Despite the fact that the auction honored her name, we know that it takes an army of individuals to make the evening a success. Okay? Many different groups, including acquisitions, decorations, catering, audio video, checkout, gift management, guest services, beverages, preview, raffles, sponsorships, setup, and teardown. So many people who love Foley have helped to make each of these evenings a success, and I would like to thank them. I would also like to appeal to them that they continue to be part of the auction. Think of it, if you would, as a lifelong commitment, like being appointed as a Supreme Court justice. Thank you to those of you who continue to help despite the fact that your children no longer attend Foley. That is truly a commitment to you that we appreciate. Thank you so much. And I know some of you were maybe asked by Amy to volunteer and so on, whether it was with a kind word from her smile, or thank you. On behalf of my family and in memory of Amy, thank you for continuing to be part of the Foley auction. The one major project that Amy did not get a chance to finish before being called home to be with her mom, dad, and sister was to get an elevator put in Bishop Foley. Despite the fact that Bishop Foley is a two-story building, at the time it was built, law did not require an elevator. Okay? Students who suffer temporary injuries or more permanent challenges miss out on the opportunity to attend classes on the second floor. What I'm asking you, if you would, if you see or are so moved, if you would, feel free to make a donation. You can make a donation during the auction, during the paddle up process. You can make a variety of different levels. Any level will be very much appreciated. The goal is to bring an elevator to Foley so that all students can benefit. All students can attend classes on the second floor. Okay. I hope that you enjoyed the evening tonight, which will end up being Bishop Foley's most unique auction ever. We were within 48 hours of being able to meet and enjoy the auction the way it traditionally has been handled. We just missed out on that. So tonight you have an opportunity to spend a wonderful evening, I hope, with family and friends, and that hopefully you have the opportunity to bid often, remembering that everything that is raised for the Foley auction will benefit the students at Bishop Foley. I pray that this will be the last time that we are unable to enjoy the auction, not in the Foley gym. And I hope that for each of you, that you share a wonderful evening. God bless you and your families, as well as Bishop Foley Catholic High School. Thank you very much and enjoy the evening.
Thank you for your heartfelt words, Rich. Now, we'd like to introduce you to a current student here at Bishop Foley Catholic, Megan. Megan is a sophomore and she is a student council representative, as well as a participant in drama and other activities. And she'd like to talk to you about what an elevator would mean for her. Hi, Megan.
Hi.
Why don't you introduce yourself to the people?
My name is Megan Dean, and I am a 10th grader at Bishop Foley Catholic High School.
Excellent. Where did you come from in a grade school?
I came from St. Paul on the Lake Catholic School in Grosse Pointe Farms, Michigan.
I understand they had just installed an elevator just before you started there. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. About when I was in preschool or kindergarten.
Wonderful. So you had the opportunity to move around the building.
Correct.
Wonderful. What do you find difficult about Bishop Foley's current building situation?
Well, as of right now, I'm unable to go upstairs. Most of the teachers that come upstairs usually come here in this lab. And I think what would be good about getting an elevator would be that I get to see their classrooms and not have to be in this lab every day. And it would make a huge difference for me.
Well, what do you think it would be for others?
Well, it would make a big difference, like if somebody hurts their leg or stuff at practices and sports and they have to use crutches or a wheelchair. It would be good for them. And if we have pregnant teachers, like I felt bad for Mrs. Atanasio when she was going to have her baby because she was going up and down the stairs a lot and it was too much pressure on that baby. That would be good for, if we have pregnant teachers in the future, that would be good for them too. And the maintenance people, if they're carrying heavy things, it's gonna be too much for them to carry stuff and go up the stairs. That would be too hard for them. So an elevator would be good for them as well.
Wonderful. What would you like to say to the people that are considering donating to the elevator fund?
I would say that they're making a big difference right now for me and for other people that would really like to use an elevator.
Wonderful. Thank you, Megan, for coming to visit with us today and letting people know what a difference an elevator could make for all of us.
No problem.
Ladies and gentlemen, section one is closed, but section two to the end is still open. Section two will be closing in 25 minutes. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to clarify a little bit of confusion that's going on with the raffles. I apologize. We can't do raffles the way we usually do, which is we walk around the gym and we sell 50-50 and we sell the jewelry items and we sell all of the card raffles. This time around, what you have to do is in section four, use the raffle option. And what you need to do is if you want to purchase more than one, what you have to do is get out of that purchase after you've done it and then refresh your URL and then go back in. Thanks a lot for your patience.
If you're interested in donating to our elevator fund, you can head straight down to the bottom of the auction catalog and you will see multiple options of donations. Please think about donating and push a button. Section 2 is closed, but Section 3 will still be open for 25 more minutes. Put your bids in, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. guys, we would love to be with you, but we can't. So show us what's happening at your house. Send us your pictures using hashtag 2020 BFC Auction. If you're interested in donating to our elevator fund, you can head straight down to the bottom of the auction catalog and you will see multiple options of donations. Please think about donating and push a button. Ladies and gentlemen, section 3 is closed. The raffle section will be closing next in 25 minutes. Come on, folks, bid up and bid often and buy those raffle tickets. If you're interested in donating to our elevator fund, you can head straight down to the bottom of the auction catalog and you will see multiple options of donations. Please think about donating and push a button. Thank you.
Hey folks, just a quick note to let you know that the 50-50 auction is up to $700. So hop in and get your chance to win $700 on the 50-50 auction. Thanks.
If you're interested in donating to our elevator fund, you can head straight down to the bottom of the auction catalog and you will see multiple options of donations. Please think about donating and push a button. If you're interested in donating to our elevator fund, you can head straight down to the bottom of the auction catalog and you will see multiple options of donations. Please think about donating and push a button. Thank you. If you're interested in donating to our elevator fund, you can head straight down to the bottom of the auction catalog and you will see multiple options of donations. Please think about donating and push a button. If you're interested in donating to our elevator fund, you can head straight down to the bottom of the auction catalog and you will see multiple options of donations. Please think about donating and push a button. Thank you. If you're interested in donating to our elevator fund, you can head straight down to the bottom of the auction catalog and you will see multiple options of donations. Please think about donating and push a button. Ladies and gentlemen, the raffle section is closed, but there's 25 more minutes for the final section of the night. I will be back shortly with the winner of all of the different raffles that we have.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am here to let you know who the winners are of our raffles this evening. Once again, I want to thank you all for coming to our virtual edition of the annual Amy Uebbing Auction and Gala. It's been a crazy year, but I really do appreciate all of you participating. We're going to start off with the AirPod Pros. This year's winner of the AirPod Pros is Rita Peterson. Woohoo! She bought ticket A1321. Just let you know. The second winner, the Bucket of Cheer. Is that the one that's coming up next, John?
Yep.
Okay, the Bucket of Cheer is up next. And the winner of the Bucket of Cheer is Pete Orvitz. All right, Pete. Pete is our chairperson for the setup committee of the auction when we have it in the gym. And hopefully my dear friend Pete will come back next year when we get to have it in the gym.
Now he has to.
That's right. All right, we're going to continue on, and we're going to go to the food tent. This is the one where there's a whole bunch of gift certificates, or gift cards, if you will, to restaurants. And the winner of the food tent gift cards is Lila Manzuk. All right, Lila. Now, Lila is also the chairperson for the cookie walk. So, by the way, buy those cookies, those jars, and the wreaths, of course. And we do have some crafts on there this year. Now, the next one. What is it, John? Food? No, not food. We did food. It's John Tech. This John Crombie guy. Tech. Whatever. All right. So the His and Hers. Is it supposed to show up there? Oh, okay. It's coming up. So the His and Hers raffle, which is the necklace and earring set, as well as a two-piece power tool set. The winner of that is Chris Uebbing.
Yeah, Chris.
All right, Chris.
The employees of Foley. Forks and everything.
There we go. One more. All right, and the final winner of the 50-50. And John, how much is there?
I believe it's $800 for the winner.
$800 for the winner for the 50-50 raffle this year. Tina Bridwell. All right, Tina Bridwell.
Congratulations, Tina.
Ladies and gentlemen, those are the 50-50 auctions this year. Oh, and all the other raffles, not just 50-50. Sorry, I got that wrong. I want to once again thank you all for joining us and dealing with our changes and the needs that we had to make in order to have this happen. Thank you all for dealing with the fact that maybe your meals came a little late. I'm sorry about that. We're working on it, but I hope you enjoyed the food. I hope you enjoyed the drinks and the desserts and all the efforts that our staff and our volunteers put in. And once again, Betty Landreth, you rock. You are the heart of Foley. And she was also the acquisitions chair. And she did a great job of keeping all of those things up and running. I think we did a good job of bidding on things. I want to really, really thank all of you for doing that. So I want to wish you all a good evening. And I want to hopefully, prayerfully think about next year. Everybody pray that next year we can all be together and enjoy the auction as it should have been. We are going to Sue Goldie. We are going to keep the decorations for that were supposed to be this year for next year. So, ladies and gentlemen, have a great evening. Love y'all. Take care. Thank you.